So Kurt, maybe we'll ask you for a quick second here. Give us a sense, what are you working on with your project here?
Well, I got inspired by Jack Shepard and his owls, and so I'm just painting one of these owls here in the on the $10 bill, and then on the other side there will be this kind of face here that's now underneath my plastic, and then I would like to have more faces that I could then put on top of the owl, so people could just choose any car or a chapel or any parent, and there will be a nail and they can hang it there. And yeah, we'll see how it works. And then there's a little bit of it's a little bit interactive, and you can play a little bit with it. And, yeah, so installation, that's what I'm doing at the moment.
Okay, Russell, give us a sense of what you've been working on here with Rip-Off Artists.
I chose Greg Curnow as my artist. First of all, Canadian, but when I was searching for an artist, I saw some of his self-images. As you can see here, I like the vibrant colors, I like the block color, and so I thought that I could interpret Sir John A. Macdonald and the $10 note utilizing his type of art style.
Okay, Enid, well, give us a sense of what you're working on over here.
Okay. The artist I've chosen is Ken Dabney, and he's done some hockey-type pictures. And I'm trying to put together the fact that Canada and hockey have grown up together, and what is Canada and what is hockey is all kind of the same thing. It determines who we are. So I have put a mask or a helmet on Johnny's head, and hopefully in a Canada World Championship shirt. This is center ice, that doesn't mean much. There's a Stanley Cup is here in the logo. I've got Paul Henderson's signature, and I'm hoping to find Johnny McDonald's to put here. I have two paintings of Danby's that I want to put in these two corners. And then I want to superimpose the whole hockey rink on top of the bill. So eventually I hope to have a $10 bill that's kind of very hockey and very Canadian.
Okay, Marion, give us a sense of what you're working on here.
What I'm doing is John A. Macdonald's on in Canadian maps. And I'm doing it in a range of eight tones of purple. This was my pre-piece, so it's in the browns, the stamp. And this is all Canadian maps. So I've chosen Emily Carr and her Strangled by Growth. So I'm going to put the image of John A. Macdonald behind where the totem head is. And then we're all putting 150 into the piece as well. So I'm going to make this hand, John A. Macdonald's hand, holding a proclamation of 150. So these purple parts will all be in map pieces. And then for the foliage, I've made some homemade papers. I might even use some air-dried clay and make it, build it out so that it's surrounding his image. We'll see as I go.
Okay, Terry, give us a sense of what you're working on.
I'm channeling Tom Thompson. So my scenes are out of doors, and I'm replacing John A. Macdonald with a moose head and trying to give a voice to the animals that grace our wonderful country.
Okay, Joanne, will tell us a little bit more about what you're working on.
Well, I'm doing the artist Mavonwy Pavlik, and she was best known for her portraits. And specifically, she did a portrait of Pierre Elliott Trudeau. It's the official portrait that hangs in Parliament. So I'm going to be working on my wooden box. I normally paint on furniture. And what I'll be doing is I'm going to try and work this the same way that she did, where I'm going to build it up. I've got black gesso on here to provide my wood. and then I'll build it up with sort of random brush strokes, and then gradually I'll get the portrait of Sir John A. Macdonald out of that. And meanwhile, I'll leave this nice wooden box as kind of a piece of Canadian history. So that's what I'm doing.